Hi there! If you've been following this series so far, you know exactly what today's video is. It's March of Robots, the final stretch, week 4.5. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe to let me know if you want to see any more art challenges. We're going to be trying out watercolour, gouache, pens and pencils. We're going to be trying out so many different mediums, and I hope this inspires you to try out different mediums in your sketchbook. The first of week 4's prompts is bloom, and I use the term robot really loosely here. I think when it comes to art challenges, it's really important that you also create what you want to create. I know a lot of people follow it very specifically, and I like the idea of doing robots, but I wanted to draw a kind of elf looking robot, and I also do a fairy later on, and I like using the colours that I like and creating what I want to create and trying to make it fit around the challenge. That's the way that I find it easiest to complete. I feel like if you zone in a little bit too much on what the challenge is and try and create art that you don't enjoy, then it's harder to complete the challenges. So I went for a cute little elf robot with flowers. The next prompt is tome, and I decided to also use my himi jelly gouache for this one. I really love the 2D illustrative style that is really easy to achieve with jelly gouache, so I decided to do this one here as well, but also because I had got my jelly gouache out and, you know, it's quite messy. I just feel like it's a lot easier to stick with the same medium if I'm on a roll, so I used it for this one as well. I decided to do a kind of creepy looking robot that's like a librarian. It's in a library, that's what I thought of for time. I really love the style of this robot. I had a few sketches of just basic robot styles, different shapes that I wanted to try, and this was the one that I did really like. Prompt 24 is reflect. Now, this one didn't quite go to plan. The idea I had was of a kind of monster robot that's a window cleaner. That was the kind of idea. And I don't know if you can tell, but I really struggled to come up with ideas for this one. I still think it's cute. I had the sketches and I had a little monster robot in there, and I knew that I wanted to do it. At this point, I wanted to cover the robots that I hadn't covered yet. You know, I wanted to make sure I had lots of different shapes and lots of different robots. And I think I definitely have variety so far in this challenge. I decided to use metallic watercolors, and the silver one just doesn't go anywhere near as opaque as the others, is what I figured out after this. You can see the silver one still looks translucent, and yet the orange and the yellows just go down so thick. I obviously learned that from this piece, but yeah, that was really unfortunate because I wanted the silver obviously to be like the skyscraper that the robot was cleaning, and it just didn't really quite go to plan. Starting the next day now, I had a few easier prompts on this day, so I decided to try and fit four in. The first one is tools, and I decided to do a robot that's just made of parts. I actually rewatched the film Robots with my partner quite recently because he'd never seen it, and Robots is an amazing film if you've never seen it. And there's a robot in there which I think it's voiced by Robin Williams, and he's kind of like made of parts, and that was kind of what inspired this one. But I decided to obviously do like a hammer and wrench and actual like tools. For the prompt cloud, I started with a watercolor background. I feel like this is one of the biggest kind of hacks that I've learned since painting with gouache. When I first started with himi jelly gouache, I remember I would do like an underpainting with really watered down gouache, and you're really setting yourself up for failure because it just reactivates so easily. So now I figured out if I do a watercolor background, then I can just paint straight on top. And I often use watercolor as an underpainting instead because it's so much easier. Watercolor is, it's so much less likely to be reactivated. This one didn't exactly go to plan though. The idea that I had was doing like a plane that, honestly, it kind of reminds me of like a Swablu from Pokemon Go. That was kind of the idea that I had that popped in my head. And then I thought of turning it into a plane that's kind of combined with clouds for wings, and it just didn't really go exactly as I had in my head. But you know, some days where you're not really completely in the mood to paint and you don't exactly have a plan, this was one of those days. Prompt 27 is remote, and I feel like there's only really two ways to go with this. That's kind of what I thought. I thought of like a remote control, and then I thought of a remote island. That was all I could really come up with. And I decided to go with a remote island. I used watercolor as the base again because it's easier, and I have more experience creating water with watercolor. Like, the technique for painting a sea is completely different with watercolour and gouache, and watercolour is just faster, really. I wanted this piece to be a lot faster because I wanted to get 4 done in this day, so there were some prompts here that I really liked and I knew I wanted to put the effort in. Some of them so far were tools and bloom, and then there were others a little bit like this one where I just wanted to do a cute little island with a face. I ended day 8 with a full watercolour piece. Honestly, I'd kind of planned to use gouache, and then I realised I've used gouache a lot in this sketchbook for this challenge, considering watercolour is my main medium. I've just found gouache has worked a lot easier on this paper, but this one, the prompt was Lance, and so I did a tiny cute little robot riding a horse, like a lance, and I was really surprised with how the watercolor worked on this one. It looks like as long as you use the watercolor for wet on dry methods and quite thickly, it looks like it works fine with the sketchbook. It seems like it's just if you use a higher quantity of water that it kind of spreads on this paper and goes a bit messy. Thank you. I started the final day with the prompt hammer and the mindset that this was going to be the final day. I did a watercolour background because I really liked how that was going, and I actually quite liked sort of tinting the page this kind of orange shade because the paper itself is actually really quite yellow, but I feel like it just looks really nice doing orange on yellow. I don't know if that makes any sense. I decided to go for a slightly steampunk vibe with this one. I've only ever done one steampunk piece before, and that was with ink for Inktober. So doing it in gouache was a very different experience. I actually didn't use a reference. I did the sketch, and I think I might have originally looked at ideas when I did the sketch, but when I was painting this piece, I didn't use a reference, and I feel like I probably should have, but I was on a little bit of a race at this point because I only had 3 left and I just wanted to, you know, get the challenge done and be able to look through the entire sketchbook. The second to last prompt is leap, and this one went wrong in every way possible. First, I decided to do a metallic watercolor background, and I did it in the silver shade, hoping that maybe I just added too much water the previous time, but again, the silver one just doesn't seem as opaque as the others, so I ended up doing a lot of different shades. Then I went in with green gouache, and I kind of remembered that I thought the green gouache was a bit more transparent than the other shades, but forgot at this point. So I was kind of surprised to learn that no matter how thick I made it, it was still quite transparent. I think the issue I made here was I was using the gouache in a really thick way to try and make it more opaque, but I don't think the layers underneath were completely dry. They looked dry, but I don't think they were completely dry. And it actually started cracking a little bit, and when it cracks, there's kind of no way back. So I added a little bit of white to the mixture to try and get opacity that way, which didn't save it. And then I decided to just crack out my colour pencils and my pen and try and go over it and hide the disastrous mess. Considering Dream is a fairy, I think Dream looks quite a lot like a robot. I really love the concept for this one. I wanted to do a fairy. I know it's a robot art challenge, but I wanted to do a fairy on a toadstool. That was just something that I wanted to do. So I did it, and I actually really like the design for this one. It looks a lot different to the initial sketch I had, which was a lot more human. But I think it definitely constitutes as a robot. I just used watercolor and I really only did it in one layer, which does mean it's lacking a little bit of contrast, but I don't really think this paper can handle too many more layers than that. This is just a little Royal Talents art creation sketchbook. It's designed for mixed media, but the GSM isn't very high and it's not fantastic with watercolor. Overall though, I'm really happy with how this one went. I love the concept, and honestly I would repaint it as like an original because I really like the concept for this one. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you caught any of my other videos in this series, honestly, it means the world. I appreciate all of your support, all of your views. I appreciate everything. Obviously, I'm going to be chilling a little bit in April, but I am thinking of doing mermaid. I've never drawn a mermaid before, but I think it might be quite interesting. So please let me know down below in the comments if you'd be interested in seeing any of mermaid. Please like and subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.